We first got into the oyster cultivation business, I guess, as an agency in the early 80s. We had the prototype oyster catcher that was developed by Clemson. And that machine was replaced by the first one was called the Oyster Bucket, I think, and then the second one was called the Oyster Catcher. In 1989, they decided to build a larger vessel, which was a 50 by 20 by 4 feet deep steel barge, twin screw, and called the Oyster Catcher 2. That boat would actually harvest intertidal oysters mechanically, put them up on the deck. You could load the deck with between 1,000 and 2,000 bushels, which is a huge boat, huge capacity. Oyster seed, take to a public shellfish ground and plant. Logistically, it was a nightmare to find the right tides, to have the machine work correctly. And so the saltwater license was there. And we made a proposal in the year 1999 to start a seed project in 2000, just to see how it'd go with the oyster shell recycling. And it took off fairly well with just a minimal amount of funding. And the first year, we were in the thousands of bushels. And we had some luck getting some used Department of Transportation equipment to handle the shell with. We found a few used pieces of equipment. We bought a tractor new, which we got a good deal on. And on a shoestring budget, really, we got started. The recycling starts when you go to a seafood retailer and buy a couple bushels of oysters for your oyster roast in the backyard. And then after the oysters are eaten, you have a pile of oyster shell there. And you're saying, what am I going to do with these things? And that's where the point where we say, okay, well, you can bring them to these conveniently located drop-off sites, throw them in the bin, we'll collect them at the end of the season, and we'll plant them back out on the beds. A lot of people, when I was building these things, thought I was building a cattle pen. And I tell them, no, it's not a cattle pen. It's an oyster shell recycling bin. You'll see a sign, a blue sign, 2x3. And you'll see what looks like a pen. Most of them now. Most of them are uniformly built, 16 feet deep, 16 across the back, and open in the front so we can move the front end of the equipment in there to get the shell out. Yeah, we have several what we call quarantine sites. Four of them in the state right now we're using. And that's where we take all the shell from that region and take it to a central site, pile it up, take the trash out, make sure the shell stays there for at least 2 months so it's quarantined to be free of disease. We'll go to a quarantine site with a front end loader and a dump truck, and we'll fill it up and we'll run loads to wherever we're going to be staging the operation from. Say this third landing here, we pile them up wherever we can close. What we have is a 40 foot by 12 foot wide, 40 feet long, 3 feet deep, flat steel barge, which carries upwards to 1,000 bushels of shell. After we get a load on board, we always measure just to make sure and get a bushel estimate. We have a formula that we use. We can get our cubic feet. And the way we do it is we say, whatever our cubic feet is, say today it was 22 feet long, 11 feet wide, and about average height of 4 feet. So we would take those numbers, get a cubic footage, and take that times 0.8036, and you get U.S. bushels. So today it was about 900, I think. 900, about 54,000 pounds, or over 25 tons. So the shell actually weighs more than the barge, much more than the barge. Our criteria for a place to plant, and again, that can vary from place to place. Generally, we want a place that's a good growing area, open to recreational harvesting, closed to commercial, because this is funded by the recreational fishing license. So we don't plant commercial areas. Everything we plant is for recreational use only. The second criteria is water quality, just in general, salinity. We like a good high salinity if we can get that. We have an ankle rule. If we get out and walk around and we sink up to our ankle, that's good. Anything past your ankle, don't even bother. So And we want to get in there and be as delicate as we can. We don't want to disturb what's there. And we want to make sure we don't dig big holes and kill live oysters. That's unacceptable. And so we're always being real careful about the negative impacts you can have when you have a big operation. Larval oysters in the water column, which have spawned within the last 2 to 3 weeks, are free swimming. They're looking for a place to attach. If they should find one of the shells we put out today, they would start their calcium carbonate shell. And of course, they'd be microscopic at first. They'd immediately commence building their shell. By the time a couple of 3 months, it'll be about as big as my little fingernail under ideal growing conditions. And then I've seen, it's not always like this, but in 18 months, you can have a 2 to 3 inch oyster. Sometimes it takes, the rule of thumb we've always used is 1 inch per year growth. So in 3 years maximum, you would have a nice harvestable oyster from the stuff we planted today. And also maps are available from our website, or you can send us in the mail for some maps. And we'll send them out, P.O. Box 12559, Charleston 29412. And just put recreational shellfishing maps on your request.